हेलो। सचिन आना ऑडिबल। अरे हेलो
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Okay, but I'm not able to see the screen. That's the reason. Just one second, let me. Are you people able to see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, how many of are we expecting some more people to join in or? Hello? Are we expecting some more people to join? Can we start?
Sir, start. Sir, you can start.
Okay. So, may I know how many are there from the Jindinwala College? How many faculties are there? If you can just introduce, or somebody can tell me, so I can see only a couple of them.
We all are from RJ College only.
Okay. Fine. So, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Soumya Ranjan, and I am from the BFSI Sector Skill Council of India. Last week, I was having a small chat with Madam Usha, and it was decided that that we should have a small little chat with the teachers of Jindinwala College, just to make them aware about the job opportunities which is there in the banking and financial services insurance sector, which would in fact give them that a little extra confidence about. To communicate to the students, to their students, as to what they should do, what steps they need to take up so that they become more job ready, and what kind of jobs they should expect, what kind of companies they should expect. Okay, so with that as the focus, we will just run through a couple of slides that I have over here, which is meant for the teachers. And it is not that not everything is known to you, many things is known to you, it's only that I'm going to reinforce some points. Okay, so if you see the screen, I believe everybody is able to see the screen right now. If somebody can just say yes, I'm going to go forward.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So good, thanks. So if you see the screen, the screen has got set of, company logos. If you see, typically there are two set of boxes, one on the right and one on the left. The left side, if you see, this is more or less looks like a IT company, and in fact they are IT companies: IBM, Infosys, Oracle, Accenture, Capgemini. then there's one which doesn't say anything, but it is actually Royal Bank of Scotland. Now, if you see the other side, the right-hand side set of companies, the logos pertain to Axis Bank, HDFC Bank, IndusInd Bank, Tata AIG, SBI Cap Securities, Murugappa Group, Janna Small Finance, IIFL, Muthoot Group. So it is distinctly clear that one set of companies are conventional finance companies, banks, insurance, and the left-hand side are, we would call them IT companies, or I would also call them fintech companies. Okay. Now, there is a relationship between these two set of companies. Most of the companies on the left-hand side work for the right-hand side company. That means they prepare their, they make their software, they make their applications, they make the entire IT infrastructure ready for these banks to operate. Otherwise, today, in this pandemic situation, banks would not have been operating had they not had those digital platforms, the net banking facility, the mobile banking facility. The Paytms of the world have emerged out of nowhere. In this last 1 year, they have, I think they have multiplied themselves. So how does the Paytm work? How does this Google Pay work? And what are they doing? Basically, they're engaging with the banks at the back end. Some of Paytm has now become a bank itself. Okay, you don't see a Paytm branch, but it is there practically in everybody's pocket. So, the banking services, the financial services have virtually got into each and every single individual, and I would say financial inclusion is actually shaping up now. So even a vada pav wala sitting at the roadside is now able to sell his vada pav using a Paytm or a Google. So his money is directly coming to his account. So everything is now known to the IT, that who is earning and who is paying. So what does it mean to us? It means quite a lot of things. That means we need to understand that any company that we see today in the space of banking, financial services, or insurance is majorly consisting of sales force. It's the sales force that you predominantly see in front of you. Okay. So, and if you see the hierarchy of the bank or a company, the junior most the junior level or the entry level population is majorly, which is the bigger size obviously, is into sales, because that is how the mapping is. So one thing that we need to understand, and we need as a faculty, as a teacher, as a mentor, as a leader, we have to bring in this idea very clear into the mind of our students that the entry to the banking financial services is much more easier and much more remunerative if you are looking at the sales component of the sector. If you look at the operations component, or if you look at the credit component, things will become a little difficult. But if you say that I am okay with sales, and I am great in sales, and I want to make money, I want to grow fast, I want to rise up the ladder, then sales is the entry point that we need to all understand. Staying away from sales is as good as saying that I'm staying away from the sector. Okay, let's now move to the next thing. So is getting into this industry difficult? Easy? So there are two options. Either it can be very easy or it can be very difficult. But the fact is, it is easy. It is very easy. All it needs, a right attitude, a right set of skills, and the right orientation of having the right knowledge. If these three things, what the companies are asking is ASK, ask. A for attitude, S for skill, and K for knowledge. If that is what they're asking for, that means they're asking for positive attitude, extrovert kind of a person who is willing to meet people, who is good on calculations and on numbers. When I say calculation number, means I don't want people to behave like Shakuntala Devi, but all I want is that they should know that if I have to find percentage, then what should be in the denominator and what should be in the numerator. Otherwise, your percentages can go haywire. Okay. The conceptual understanding of time value, concept of money should be very clear. Okay. The way the interest rates are calculated, the impact of compounding interest vis-a-vis the simple interest should be known. Discounting, the component of discounting should be known. Present value of cash flow should be understood. Now these are some of the technical things. Not that everything should be known to everybody, but if it is understood, that is good. And what is not been understood, it's fine, but you should have a very good mindset that whenever I get an opportunity, I will grab it. Because not everything is known to everyone. Next is, once I am there inside the company, I should have the attitude of learning the product and the process very fast. I should be able to handle my documents very nicely. I should be able to communicate verbally and in written, both ways. I should be good in negotiation. Negotiation doesn't mean that you negotiate and lower down the cost or lower down the price. It is always negotiation means to negotiate and close the deal. And the most important thing, it is kept at the bottom, but it is the most important thing, is that stay customer centric. Understand the customer's requirement and try to fulfill his requirement rather than your requirement, because his requirements are ultimately going to be your requirement, if not today, tomorrow. So with this set of combination of attitude, skill, knowledge, if this is there, entry into BFSI is a cakewalk. So most of the college students who display this characteristic are in. That much of guarantee that I can say very confidently of my 25 years of experience in this sector. But I can also say that if this characteristics is not consistently displayed, the entry is very smooth and the exit is equally smooth. So that's the thing. But nevertheless, let's understand how big is this industry and what it all consists of. If you see the three pillars, the three regulatory bodies, the Reserve Bank of India, the Securities Exchange Board of India, the Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India. These three regulatory bodies actually control the entire Indian financial system. So the RBI takes care of the bank and the NBFCs. The SEBI controls the entire capital market operation. All the capital market products are controlled by them, including the mutual fund. So all the IPOs, all the debentures, all the mutual fund products are regulated by them. The insurance companies, the insurance broking companies, the third party administrators, all are under the control of IRDA. Whether it is a life insurance company or a general insurance company, or it's a health insurance company, or any third party service provider, or surveyor or assessor, under this, working in this particular subsector, is governed by the rules and regulations of IRDA. Now you see the kind of companies, number of companies which exist, the number of banks which are a part of the NEFT system, okay, National Electronic Fund Transfer System. There are 221 banks. I am not counting the rural banks. I am not counting the cooperative banks, which are in the rural segment or which are not a part of the NEFT. They can run into thousands. But I'm talking about those banks which form the part of the NEFT. That means where you can do RTPS transfer, IMPS transfer. 221 banks all put together. One bank, if I name, is let's say State Bank of India, which has got more than 1.5 lakh branches. Okay, so just imagine if all the nationalized bank and all the private sector banks are put, how where the numbers will go. NBFCs, some 9,000 NBFCs are there. I'm saying forget about 9,000. Let's talk about 500 NBFCs. That is also quite a good number. Stockbroking companies, there are about 200 odd stockbroking companies. 44 mutual fund companies are there. 57 insurance companies are there. 7,000 mutual fund distributors are there. Okay, so distributor is a combination of business plus corporate, individuals per corporate. But I am talking about 7,000 corporate distributors. Insurance broking companies, 700 insurance broking companies are there. Chota Mota put together, all 700 insurance broking companies. This market also allows you to work for your own, work as an entrepreneur, work as a businessman. Not necessarily that you should be under a wage employment, but you can be under self-employment. So both mutual fund and insurance give individual enough capability to set up his own mutual fund, own business, setup. Own business entity and drive it. Obviously, he's going to he cannot directly make his own products. He will have to sell the product which is available from the AMFI or SEBI approved. But he has a standardized commissions that he can earn and which are absolutely legitimate. So what are the various job roles that is there, which our students should know with respect to the, I'm talking about the entry level job roles which can go into banks and NBFCs. So when I say private banks, I mean to say large private banks. I'm not talking about the PSU banks because their entries are totally different. We are not even touching them. So large private banks, you can name it Axis, HDFC, ICICI, all these banks. Small finance banks, you can be Equitas, Surodhay Finance, Ujjivan Finance, Janas Finance, some 11 banks are already existing and they are flourishing. Payment bank, you have Paytm, you have India Post Payment Bank, Airtel Payment Bank. So they have just started off. Housing finance companies, which are typically NBFCs, and the microfinance companies, which are also NBFCs. Housing finance, you have a range of housing finance companies. Some cater to the upper segment of the society, some cater to the lower segment of the society. When I say lower society, lower segment means I'm talking about the affordable housing finance. A big, growing sector with the support that is coming from government. Of subsidizing people who are buying smaller houses. Microfinance companies are invariably coming up at various locations and they're growing very fast. Yes, there is a require. They require people in great quantity. They require smart guys, but they require people from mediocre families who have empathy, sympathy for poor people. It is not that those who are men who come to the college in the Mercedes can probably work for a microfinance. Very difficult because microfinance companies work with the downtrodden. They would work with the roadside street vendors, but they make good money and they do good business as well. So the openings are typically sales executive, retail, sales executive, assets, loan processing officer, debt recovery officer, customer service officer, and operation executive. These are the typical the roles that is there. But the top three or top four, I can say, is the sales, retail sales, retail liability, retail assets, they are the ones which are in very high demand. And at any point of time, if you want, if some candidate wants to get in, they can look into it. So, like every coin has a two sides. Even banking also has got two sides. But we'll discuss about that a little later. I'll just run through this fast. Same goes with the insurance and capital markets. Health is at the most in demand. So I have spoken about the insurance, life, health, general health, broking company, third party surveyors and assessors, capital market, mutual funds, stock broking companies, wealth management companies are there. So if you start naming one can start naming 50, 60, 100 companies under each segment. So let me get into the job roles, which exactly are there in the minds of the employer. What is the job role that he has? Like, for example, insurance agent is a job role which is in heavy demand. Heavy demand in the sense, I am telling you, if somebody says, ki, sir, mujhe kuch nahi mil raha hai, mujhe kya karna chahiye, mujhe kuch direction nahi mil raha hai, I am saying, if he says, ki, main insurance agent banna chahta hun, the next day morning, he can start his work. Next day morning, he can join a company. The next day morning, wherever he goes, they'll pick him up and put him in the training. Whether he succeed or not is a different thing, but there will be a path that can be drawn for him. There can be a career chart that can be drawn for him. Whether he works on that systematically is a different thing. So what does the job description exactly mean? Most of you know it, but I'll just reiterate. Insurance agent is responsible for sourcing clients, selling life and non-life products, supporting an application process, providing post-policy services and assisting in claim processing. The individual at work sells insurance policies to individuals and then ensures collection of periodic premiums from the policyholder. The individual also ensures that approved beneficiary receives the designated financial statement settlement from the claim on the policy. So there are a couple of things which are very conventional. The tools have changed, the scenario is changing. A payment, now you don't run to the customer saying that he gives me a check, you say, okay, sir, online payment kar dijiye. But somebody, there has to be a mechanism as to how this payment needs to be followed up, because not everybody does it on time. There are many who don't do it on time, and that is the reason why you need to follow up with these people, because insurance is something which is a contract. So if the fulfillment of the contract is not happening by the insurance policy holder, he loses the benefit of the contract, what the contract says, which is supposed to be given by the insurance policy issuer. Mutual fund agent is the next most sought after program. Before I move to the mutual fund, I'll just make one statement. Insurance, though the name may be having some stigma, okay, agent hai, kya hoga, kaisa hoga, what people will say. But I can tell you, there are banks who want people with knowledge of insurance and solid knowledge of insurance, because banks are the premium insurance policy seller as on date. So if somebody does a course on this, or is extremely confident about the insurance insurance process, he has a better chance to get into the bank and survive and then sustain and grow. Next is mutual fund. Again, banks do sell heavily mutual fund to their customers. They would advise people not to keep money in the bank account, but to put it in the mutual fund. Why? The reason is very simple, because they earn some money out of it. Okay. So candidates who learn about mutual fund, they are practically sure about what to do if a customer is asking about a debt fund or a equity fund or a balanced fund or a tax linked or equity linked mutual fund. Probably they are the blue-eyed boys for the company, for the banks, and they can be picked up like hotcakes. So what this exactly the mutual fund agent job role is? The mutual fund job role is all about being responsible for facilitating buying and selling a mutual fund, providing post-sale service. The individual at work offers mutual fund to the prospective investor, maintains a record of their investment, conducts regular market research to advise customers, and provides post-sale service. So a lot of insurance officers or the sales officers, they keep communicating to the customer that what is the time that is that the market is going through. If the market is going through a downward swing, they will say, sir, please buy more. This is the right time. If it is going through an upward swing, they'll say, okay, sir, if you wish, you can book your profit and come out of it. So this kind of investment, this kind of advisory requires some kind of research that the mutual fund officer needs to collate or take it from his research team and communicate to the customer. Loan processing officer is a job role which is mostly from the retail asset side, NBFCs, banks, microfinance companies, anybody who's into lending business, whether it is a car loan or a two-wheeler loan or a personal loan or a housing loan or affordable housing loan or a credit card or a SME finance or equipment finance or agriculture loan, every loan is ultimately a way of calculating the risk that the bank or the lender is going to take on a borrower. So this particular job role defines that the loan officer evaluates, authorizes, or recommends approval of loan application of people and businesses. The task involves including compiling of loan application file, performing the preliminary check, approving loans, and submitting recommendations for loans beyond their limit for further processing. So when I say preliminary checks, means they do KYC checks, they do financial checks, they do the banking statement checks, they do physical checks, okay, of the asset which is going to be on which the money has to be given or against which the money has to be given. It's very satisfying and stable job, loan processing officer. Microfinance executive. The companies are typically small in nature. The job is a little hard, but it is meant for that strata of the society which is moving from the bottom to the medium. And the students from that segment are the most appropriate guys to start their career. So what this microfinance executive does is responsible for selling micro loans, micro savings, micro insurance, micro pensions, predominantly to the financially excluded. That means they would touch people who do daily wage kind of activities, you know, those who sell products on the street every day morning and then take their cash back, and then next day morning they come back again with their new finished raw material or half finished raw material and then convert that into finished goods. And that's what I mean to say, like, you know, creating, selling vada pav, you bring in your batata and all this stuff onto the selling market and onto the market, and then prepare vada pav, sell it up, take the money, go back. So these small business owners need funding. They need working capital, and this working capital is provided by the microfinance executive. They approach so that means the microfinance individual executive as an individual works. His work is all about identifying a potential customer or a group of customers, evaluate the potential in that location, source the customer, that means actually engage with the customer, assist in the application and the loan disbursement process, collect the required fee and the installment thereafter. So that is the basic job of this microfinance executive. It needs a lot of legwork, needs a lot of communication, meeting people, talking to people, listening to their requirements very carefully, identifying whether the customer is a genuine customer or a fraudulent customer. All these characteristics are very much required for this session. Next is business correspondent and business facilitator. Again, a very entry level job role for from the bank's point of view. Typically, this job role that is there is meant for rural market. But as a product, as a learning mechanism, as a learning tool, if somebody is even learning it, it will help him in building up his confidence when it comes to actually executing or giving interviews or facing you know, the customer as to what are the various products which are sold by the bank in the market. So business correspondent and business facilitator are the representative of a bank, responsible for building awareness and sourcing prospective customers. The BC is also responsible for carrying out the banking transaction for the existing customers. That means they can, on the field, they can collect and pay money to the customer. The BC, as an individual at work, is an agent for selling banking product services, opening accounts, executing deposits, payments, transfer transactions. And the business facilitator, the individual at the work, introduces the bank's product to the unbanked segment and assists the bank in collecting the receivables, including bad debts. So the facilitator is typically the guy who reaches out to the unbanked. So if you see, the microfinance executive and the BCBF is more or less the two sides of the same coin. Only thing is, one works with the bank, second works with the microfinance. One works with the bank, second one works with the NBFC. Okay. Debt recovery agent, ultimately, after all the money has been distributed, somebody has to collect it back. If not paid properly, on time, regularly, then these people come into picture. They are appointed as a debt collector. They act as an agent of the banks. They make calls, reach out to the customer, visit the debtor, collect the money, and deposit the money back into the bank or the lender's pocket. But they have to do all this activity without violating the regulations which has been defined by Reserve Bank of India. So debt recovery is also a very important aspect of the lending, because any company which is not able to, that doesn't have a recovery mechanism, is eventually heading for a bad time. So they need people to work in this segment also. So I have just given you some of the very preliminary job roles which are there in the market, and as a faculty, you can actually communicate to your students that whatever they are learning presently in their BBA or BCom or BAF or BBI, banking insurance, everything is appropriate. That is, nothing which is wrong with it. Okay. But the only thing is that you have to test it against something. So there are two things that we are offering to the college, which that means we are communicating to the college. One, we are conducting a very small short-term online course on basics of banking and insurance, which is, the cost is around 2,360 rupees, all inclusive. It's a 16-hour program, online, given to the student through a live class by a individual, by a trainer. It is not a video that will run on its own, whether you like it or not. It's an interactive session where the student, if he doesn't understand what exactly he is going through, or he has the topic that is there, he can ask. So this is something which would recommend for people in their first year or second year to know whether they are in the right track or the wrong track. If they are building up their base, if they are building it in the right way, eventually they can take right decisions. Second offer that we have is that for all the job roles that I mentioned a minute back, you know, all the job roles that I said, these job roles can be self-assessed. That means a student can come forward, make a payment to BFSI SSC, that is 800 rupees plus the GST amount, and can take an assessment 15 days down the line, 1 month down the line, 2 months down the line, as he wishes, so that he collects his certificate and prepares and accumulates the certificate one after another, and becomes you know, confident about how to engage with the employer, because you don't know what kind of job opportunities will come. It can be a mutual fund job, it can be insurance job, it can be bank job. So holding couple of certificates is always better. So we are not trying to say that you spend thousands of rupees to build up, learn everything. I'm saying whatever you're learning from the college is absolutely fine. Okay, but when you learn something and you head towards a what do you call a degree, at the same time it is good that somebody, you do an extra effort of giving one exam. And this examination, you don't have to go anywhere, it will happen in your house, in the comfort of your residence, but it will be online. But it is very, very strict. It is as strict that it's a remotely proctored assessment. That means if the system finds that there is somebody who is trying to cheat the system, it will immediately reject him. So that's the thing. So with that care, people can get their certificate. Why these certificates? Because as a sector skill council, we also are we also have the mandate to provide apprentices. So those who are holding certificates are the people who are there on database, and we keep informing them about the job opportunities which are there from the companies by way of apprentice or as a full-time employment. So these are the two things. One is our basic course. If somebody is not very confident about the banking insurance, whether to start or to go deep dive into it, this course can be taken up very short term, 16 hours, 2 hours for 8 days, and self certification. If you are confident that you can take up any of the job roles which I have mentioned, so with that, I think I have tried to give some idea about the job roles that that is existing in the market. Which is entry-level job roles. There are other job roles which are there, which I'm not mentioning, which are typically after people do their CA, they either they do their chartered accountancy, or they become cost accountancy, or they complete their MBA. So I'm not getting into those things. I mean, I'm not talking about equity research or investment banker or you know, derivative traders, because they are very high and they're very risky. So that requires typically post-graduation and very high level of involvement, but eventually all these people can reach over there. So with that, I would like to complete my presentation and say thank you to all those who have been listening to me, and I would like to take up some questions, so that probably there must be something in your mind which you'd like to ask. So I'm open to it now. Thank you.
Thank you very much for your time. Our teachers are very well versed with all these things, and I'm sure they will have a couple of questions in terms of placement. So teachers, you can ask.
Yeah, you can ask me anything about placement.
They can unmute themselves.
Yeah, so just as Usha ma'am mentioned, you know, after the students have gone through the certification courses, what next? The placement part. Huh. Is there any guidance?
Rekha madam, they will be sharing the curriculum with us. So what we can do is, anyway, I think your syllabus is much beyond that curriculum. So if you give them some tests, Mr. Ranjan also said he has a lot of placement inquiries. So what my suggestion to you all will be to strengthen our placement cell, and you also make one group.
Yeah.
Okay, because ultimately our aim is each one should get a job from Jhunjhunwala College. And I'm very sure this partnership with BFSI, with Mr. Shukla being our own alumni, will help us achieve this target. Can you throw some light on that, Mr. Ranjan?
Yeah. So one thing is there, that there are job opportunities which keep cropping up, and we can keep posting all the job opportunities to the SPOC. We can have one single point of contact with Jhunjhunwala College, whoever is there. So from our side, Sachin would be communicating all those openings that is there. And but also I would say that some students who are keen, who are interested, who would like to take up some certificates, if they want, which they can take up certificates that adds value. So it becomes easy for us to also to communicate to the potential employer that we will be, some of the certificate holders are going to come forward. Second, I would say that for apprentice, we have companies who are looking for, you know, fresh graduates to join them as apprentice. So now apprentice is something which is...
Like an internship?
No, ma'am. Actually, it's not an internship. It is a full-time training, on-the-job training for 1 year. So a student...
But will they give... 1 minute. Will they give them money?
Yeah. It is a contract wherein... it's as per the Apprentice Act, the student gets into a contract with the company. And this contract is registered with the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. So it is, there is a portal called apprenticeshipindia.org, where I would request all the students. It's a free portal. Everybody can go and join it over there. In fact, once students are registered, they can then communicate to BFSI SSC for their job opportunities by mentioning their applicant code. So every student who registers over there gets a app ID, that means apprentice ID. And that apprentice ID, if you communicate to us into our portal, we know, because knowing through app ID becomes easier than knowing through name, because there can be, say, 10 Kavitas, but an app ID cannot be of 10 Kavitas. It has to be one app ID for one Kavita, whoever it is. So what we are going to do is, we will work in close collaboration. There are different kind of companies, big and small. I would not like to say that we will only give big companies. There are smaller companies also, but they give you the opportunity, they give the students the opportunity to learn. And no student is getting married to a company. It's about a 1 year of engagement, and then you proceed forward and make careers. So we will have enough sessions in between with the students, you know, giving them input as to how they can enhance their career. So, but to start is very important. The starting is very important. So wherever apprentice is
covered. You leave, but next day you wait. ठीक है वो लोग तो आते थे ना क्योंकि ये तो कौन तो आई नहीं वो भी उस दिन भी संडे को गया
या रेखा मैम यू हैव एनी अदर पॉइंट एनी क्वेश्चन और समथिंग व्हिच हैव नॉट क्लेरिफाइड
तेरे को तो जॉइन
वी वुड वांट टू सी द करिकुलम आई मीन द कंटेंट ऑफ द
या सो व्हाट वी कैन डू सचिन कैन फॉरवर्ड करिकुलम फॉर ऑल द कोर्सेज दैट वी हैव वेयरएवर वी हैव द क्वेश्चंस We can, the job roles, we will send you the curriculum. These curriculums will definitely ask for some practical approach, which the student can, I think, should be able to do it. Smart people can always do, overcome that particular degree of difficulty. But majorly the theory part remains the same. I don't think anybody should find problem in closing on the or covering the theory part. It will be taken care of, must have taken care by you. I'm very sure about that. So we will send you that. You can make it run through the students, the ones who are interested, who are aggressive, can always come forward. We have, you won't believe, we have students from different part of the country, calling up saying that, sir, mujhe ye wala course ka exam dena hai. I said, okay, fine, go ahead. And they give it. So we are very, very open, not like a typical, a bureaucratic thing that nobody talks to nobody here. People talk to everyone. Whoever is approaching us, we talk to them. So curriculum will be made available to you. We can make some sample questions available to you just for your
reference.
Yeah.
Okay, sir.
And sir, what are the charges for the certification courses?
I told the certification courses will be for 800 rupees. The certificate is for 800 rupees. The assessment is included in that. So 800 plus the GST, that means it comes around 944 rupees. So that is what it is. In fact, we are willing to even go ahead and make a statement that if one individual student, he wants to go for, say, two certifications, then we will give him a 10% discount. If he is making a payment of, say, two certifications, we will give him a 10% discount on both of them.
And do students need to register through online mode, or there is some procedure?
No. The it's on invitation. You have to first communicate with us by there is a link which is there on the website on which you have to go and show your interest that I want to give the thing. We send you a communication saying that these are the courses. These are the on to this account you have to make a payment, and you have to then inform us that this is the choice. Then our counselor will call up and take a date. The date will, once it is fixed, because what happens is that students don't really understand that whether they can give the examination in 1 month's time or 2 months' time. So we normally check with the student and tell them, okay, fine, I think you should take a month or two to prepare and then give. It should not be that randomly somebody picks up because ultimately it's money, you can't waste the money just like that.
Yes, yes.
So we have not gone into an auto mode kind of thing that you pay the money and the next very minute the examination will start. We have not gone to that. We are still very conventional. We talk, we reach out to the student, ask him whether are you prepared. In fact, we have gone to the extent that the student says, okay, fine, I have understood. Ye toh main de hi nahi sakta, mereko malum hi nahi hai. Then he says, okay, fine, please collect your money back. So we refund the money also.
Okay.
So the idea is not to take the money and keep it with us. I'm just saying that there are some instances where we have paid the money because the student then realized that it is not his cup of tea, but he has paid the money thinking that this will happen. Realized that he doesn't have a background. So we tell him, are you sure you want to give this examination? If he says no, it seems difficult. So we say, okay, fine, give us your account number. And maybe the same from the account that he has paid, we return the money to that account.
Okay.
So if you have seen the recent advertisement which came out from State Bank of India, this was in the month of December, they had opened up a position of 8,500 apprentice pan India, where they were looking for graduates. So those who have passed, they need to appear for the test. So very shortly, we are planning to come out with a test which is called BFSI Aptitude Test. It's called BAT. This is something, a test will be there. It will be very nominally priced, but it basically tests the ability of a person on his quantitative grasp. The kind of his logical reasoning abilities, his verbal communication. So a small test just to know in the same lines the way a banking company would have tested him. But why we are doing that? So that there are many companies who who needs some kind of a proof that if I'm going to call this boy for an interview, is he good in English? Is he good in mathematics? Is he good? When I say mathematics, means basic arithmetic. Is he good in logical reasoning? Otherwise, what happens? Companies waste a lot of time in interviewing a wrong guy, and then they end up and time is money. So if the entire day has gone and 10 people have been interviewed and nobody gets selected, it's a waste of time from both the sides. So the Sector Skill Council has been approached by many companies saying, sir, aap kuch kariye. Why don't you give us filtered list of candidates with their result, that what kind of what kind of score they have. So sometimes they ask us, you give us people with above 70% mark in quant. So we will try and give them. But it is very easy to say, but difficult to do. But we haven't started it yet. But we are planning that we will be running this Pan India and creating a database of students who actually can handle the BFSI job role, because it's very, very sensitive. It works, it deals with money, and people are they're very sensitive to the fact that their money is at stake, and they are going to deal with an individual where either they are borrowing or they are putting their money as an investment. So, and BFSI has been, somehow it has got this thing attached to it of high level of mis-selling. That people don't understand what exactly they are saying. Either the parties, the seller, the selling boy also doesn't understand what is he saying, and the receiving end definitely doesn't understand what he's listening to. And both of them say, yes, yes, karlo, karlo. And then later on it happens that after a couple of years, if it is the borrower says, mujhe to pata hi nahi tha ki mereko itna interest lagane wala hai. Usne to mereko khali 1% bola. 1% per month or 1% per annum, ye pucha hi nahi. Isne bataya bhi nahi. And then, it so happens that if I come and tell you that it's 3%, the loan is at 3%, and you don't ask me whether this is 3% per month or 3% per annum, and very happily somebody has taken the loan at 3%, thinking that it's per annum, though, and when the interest rate actually gets debited to his account, he gets a shock of his life. He has a 36% per annum. So it happens. So it's very important that we should have the right kind of set of people. So
one more question.
Yeah.
So what if the students do not want to enroll into the course, but just do the certification, just apply for certification?
Yeah, yeah, that is what I'm saying. So there are two options.
One, precisely, that is what he said. They don't have to do the course. They will do our course and appear for their exam and get certified.
Correct.
This entire meeting is for that.
Okay.
That course that I mentioned is only 2000 wala. It is only for those who are not very confident, and if they want to, some people are there who want to prepare themselves for the interview, or they want to have a one-to-one with a faculty and check whether their queries can be resolved or not. Some of them are there. So it is meant for them, 16 hours of program, but not necessary. I think this is for a student in Bombay and a student of Jhunjhunwala. I don't think they should really get bothered about taking up a basic course on banking and finance, insurance. I think they can straight come and sit for the exam and collect their certification.
Right,
ma'am.
Yeah.
I think what I should do is, Sachin, we should we should circulate yours and mine email ID, and I think all the faculty can have this with them. So if in case tomorrow at any point of time they have any query, they are always free to write to us and take the input.
I will do now, I will send list of curriculum to Suni ma'am, then she can circulate internally.
Sure, with Usha ma'am's leadership, I don't think anybody would have much of a query. But we would be more than happy to, if at all something is there, we will answer it to the best of our ability. And secondly, we would need a lot of participation from the students when it comes to job openings, I mean, you should push the student ki bhai jao, interview dekar aao. See, not all jobs are very, very aspiring, but we know that all the five fingers are not of the equal size. You know, there can be some student who's needy, who comes from a family where he needs the job very urgently or importantly. So he should start off. Staying back for the best in the world is not a very great idea. But starting and then moving forward, you should set the ball rolling. That is the basic thing. And that gives lot of confidence on the student that he starts earning even 7,000 rupees per month or 9,000 rupees per month. His morale gets boosted by not by addition but by multiplication. That's much I can say. Fine. Anything else? Anyone would like to ask?
Sir, most important, how do we go about it?
Ma'am, you
see,
tell.
Otherwise, there will be this meeting, and then again,
tomorrow, Mondays we are off. Tuesday, you will have a list of all the curriculums. List of all the list of QPs. all the question banks.
We okay.
Will give you some sample question papers of all just for your.
Okay.
Okay. Then second is that we will provide you the account details and the email ID where the students can apply. Send a mail. And check for a request that what is that they would like to do best. They can send their CVs also. So,
Rekha, madam, Rekha Shetty.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah.
Can you coordinate this activity?
Sure. Yes.
Because
ma'am.
You make one group. See, BBI is the one which becomes a bichara this thing department. So I want the BBI students to get benefit out of it.
Yeah.
So you make one group. And Mala Goplani will help you from BBI.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So that you all can, whatever placements are available, Ranjisa will put in group as well as will pass to DB because he should be also aware, right?
Yes.
But then placement through this BFSI will be your group ka commitment.
In fact, ma'am, Usha ma'am, even I am...
Will you take this responsibility?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes, ma'am.
We and take all... Akash Gupta from BMS. Right?
Okay, ma'am. Okay.
You want this one? Abni Jewel, then BBI Amala Goplani.
Yes, ma'am.
Then Akash Gupta from BMS. And you from BAF and overall coordination, Rekha, you will do. Because yes, too many ma'am. People coordinating will become very difficult then.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay,
ma'am.
Madam?
Yes.
And then you will send a weekly or fortnightly report to the principal.
Okay.
Principal tells me. So there is no need to tell me again. So okay. Once you send it to the principal, he communicates to me. Okay.
Great.
So thank you very much, Mr. Ranjan. Thank you, Mr. Shukla, for
thank
your
you,
time.
Ma'am.
In fact, Usha ma'am, I am thankful to you for giving us such a great opportunity within such a short notice. I mean, I have never seen any organization or any company acting that electrifying speed that you have done.
Yeah, we are next to lightning. Lightning. Principal is very much here. He would like to say a word.
Okay. Yeah.
Hello, sir. Very good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening, sir.
Our little discussion on the other day translated into a real interaction with the students. I'm very happy about it.
Yeah.
And we shall continue this association for the better opportunities for us.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir. I will start the meeting and end the meeting. Take care. Happy Holi.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you all, ma'am. The same. Thank you, everybody.
Happy Holi, all. Thank you, ma'am.
Front camera on. Bye.
Bye, bye, bye.
Bye, bye, ma'am.